Welcome, Cancer and Cross Watchers. This is Mystic Intuition bringing you a general love reading. Please keep in mind, time is fluid, so whenever you view this, it could represent a past, a present, or a future event for you. If it does not resonate for you, and even if it does, be sure to check out your moon, your rising, and your Venus sign for additional messages and guidance. There are always timestamps in the description box if you would ever like to skip ahead. For Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, please, Spirit. In love and in life, it needs to come through for Cancer. Confidence is key to your success. That's Leo energy. We have nothing will come of the situation. Don't panic just yet. Hold on. Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, please, Spirit. It needs to come through in love and in life. What needs to be known, seen, and understood for Cancer, please, Spirit. Cancer, I'm going to read your energy at the top. There's the bottom, but this is general, so it can be flipped or reversed. The Chariot, Cancerian energy. We have the Ten of Pentacles, the Six of Wands, the Eight of Cups, and the Page of Wands. We have the Hierophant, the Ace of Wands, the Death card, the Emperor, and the Knight of Wands. Under the deck here we have the Magician. So Gemini, Virgo energy. I feel like you've been working really hard to manifest this connection with this person, but it feels like the odds are stacked against you. It feels like you want to move toward this person, but maybe you have a family or they do. Maybe someone here has, you know, a higher level of commitment, and it's keeping you both from having this new beginning and passion, you know, because it kind of feels like you have to walk away from your situation or they have to walk away from theirs in order to make something happen here. I'm actually looking for a deck. We have X, so breakup, separation, stop the pattern, silent treatment, and abandonment. The Golden Mirror, so self-absorbed narcissist, one-sided relationship, and love bombing. Under the deck here we have Lightning, so sudden change, shocking news, surprise, epiphany, upheaval, and transformation. I feel like a lot of this was very unexpected. I feel like you're trying to move toward this person, but there's obstacles, there's blocks that keep you from them. Okay, we have Cancerian energy, we have Earth energy, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. You know, it feels like maybe you have an obligation, a responsibility in your situation, and you can't just detach from that. Maybe your person does, okay? But when I see this card in this deck, it's about preparation, okay? You don't just hop in the car and go. It's like, okay, well, I gotta pack my bags, I need to get my wallet, my keys. Okay, well, I need to, you know, fill up the gas tank first. You know, I can't just set off on an adventure, okay? There's preparation. They have to saddle the horse up first, right? They have to work on it. I'm even seeing them kind of like coaxing this horse. It's kind of like you may have to give this person a lot of reassurance, or you may need a lot of reassurance that things will work out, because whatever is at stake here is a big deal. I mean, you could work with this person, okay? Someone here could be a public figure. Whatever the case is, there's some kind of financial tie in this situation where it's hard for you to walk away from this, or it's hard for them to walk away from this. You do want to be successful here, but I feel like, let me put the scenario out there. Eight of Cups is not nothing, okay? It's not nothing. You put time and energy into that. At one point, that Eight of Cups, you built those cups one by one in your past situation, or they did, okay? That's time, energy, and emotion put into something. And to just walk away from that, whether it is a person, a family, if it's a job, if it's your childhood home, whatever that is, whatever you're leaving behind, at one point it was everything you thought you want and needed. Maybe it's what they thought they needed. and to leave it behind, it's hard. I also feel like for a lot of you, and as Cancers, you're very compassionate people, very empathetic people. You know, you definitely don't want to hurt somebody else. It's not your intention. I kind of feel like for some of you too, like let's just put this scenario out there and say that your person's in a karmic relationship. I think that some of you even, you know, it's like you want to be happy. You want your victory. But, you know, your intention was not to hurt the karmic, no matter what that person is like, okay? It's like your heart is too big. There's too much love in it. There's too much empathy in it. You care. You know, your intention was not set out to hurt someone or walk away from your situation. You know, it's hard walking away from that, walking off into the unknown. It didn't work out. You gave it a chance. It didn't work out. It's time for something new. You're ready for your win, okay? Or your person is, right? Can be reversed, cross watchers. We have the Page of Wands here, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy. There's communication in here. It's like finally that portal, that door is opening for you. Someone here is seeing that someone, the other person wants to work on this. So it's making plans, preparation to leave a situation or change a situation. It's time, right? You're ready. It's time. Time to make the change here. Now, in your person's energy here, we have the Hierophant, Taurus energy, and the Ace of Wands. It's kind of like, I feel this person kind of stuck. Or they see you as stuck, right? The Hierophant. Maybe you both are, okay? That could be what I'm picking up on here. The situation, though, with the Hierophant, it's like someone has a responsibility. Someone has an obligation to their situation. They're trying to do the right thing. But they're sitting here, this 9-to-5 kind of energy, okay? Day in and day out, it's boring, it's mundane, they're learning from this, they're growing from this, they're doing the right thing, okay? But it's keeping them from their passionate new beginning with someone else. Someone they feel that spark with, someone they feel drawn to, someone where they have this intense chemistry, okay? They want this. This is the hope. In their space here, we have the Death card, Scorpionic energy. They know that something has to end for something new to begin, okay? Death brings endings, brings beginnings, brings transformation. And I know a lot of you get sick of hearing that, you know, but this is a beautiful card. It's like, if it can't be the way that it was, it can come back stronger than it was before. It's like if you were determined to have something, but you kept getting knocked back down, each time you don't just go, oh, well, I fell off the horse once. I'm never going to try it again. No, it's, well, now I know how to do it better. Now I can reinvent myself, come back stronger, reapproach this stronger, overcome this hurdle, surpass this obstacle, make changes. Okay, the Death card, transformation. It's a beautiful energy. This person, they know that something has to change here. They're standing in this Emperor energy. They could be an Aries or have strong Aries in their chart. You could have strong Aries in your chart. But the Emperor is the embodiment of all kings. This is somebody who's incredibly intelligent. They're compassionate. They're stable. They're fiery. They have this energy, this enthusiasm about them. This is somebody who takes control. They take charge. And they know how to do this. This is somebody who has decided, I don't want to just spend the rest of my life sitting behind this desk. You know, meanwhile, the love of my life is in the other room, you know, filing papers, okay? And we can't be together. Or, you know, I'm sitting here at home on the sofa every day eating cheese puffs and watching the news with my karmic partner and we're unhappy. I want that flame in my life and I don't want anything to stop me from having that. This person is moving towards you as this Knight of Wands. More strong fire energy, okay? They're passionate about you. And they want to make things right. I do feel though, and I want to say this, this person's deciding that they can't deal with this boring life anymore. You or them, okay? Someone is tired of the repetitive, boring, everyday kind of thing. They want excitement. They want to feel alive. They want to feel that spark, that flame again. They want somebody by their side who's going to make them excited. Now, either they're waiting for you to detach from a situation till the coast is clear, till they can come in here and save the day, or they're waiting to do this. Whatever the case may be, I think that whatever the situation, I think you're empathetic to it. You understand this hiccup. Maybe they've been at this job for 15 years and it's taken them forever to get this promotion. And now they're terrified to tell HR, okay, because they don't know what's gonna happen. Maybe this person's in the military and it's always been their dream, okay? Now here they are, but they're stuck and they can't come towards you, okay? Maybe this person is older than you, okay? The emperor. Maybe they're older than you, and what would people say about that, okay? This could be your teacher. This could be your boss, okay? This could be a client of yours. This person could be in a relationship. Whatever the situation is, there's something about this. I mean, you guys could come from different religious backgrounds or different cultural backgrounds, and maybe your families wouldn't approve of each other, okay? There's hiccups along the way here, but this person's deciding they don't want to wait. But I do want to say this. This person is coming towards you, but I feel they're coming at to you as a Knight of Wands, okay? I feel like they're coming towards you with passion. I don't feel like they're offering their heart to you. I don't feel like they're offering stability. It's like, I want excitement in my life. I'm tired of this boring, everyday, 9-to-5 kind of energy, this mundane kind of thing. I want something real, something exciting again. But they're not making, it's like they're making slow progress in their situation, but I don't see them like fully ending it. Does that make sense? It's kind of like, well, I told the karmic I want a divorce, right? Or I gave my notice at work, but we still have to kind of keep things quiet right now. Like, that's that kind of energy. And I think their energy is still very inconsistent, even though they do want something here with you. It's like this person's coming in here, reasserting their energy here, coming in here to you, Leo energy, with this newfound confidence. They're determined, they're bound and determined at this time, okay? They want to manifest this new beginning with you. And I do want to say that some of you actually could be getting pregnant. Because, I mean, with this kind of energy, it feels like it's been a long time awaited, okay, is what I want to say. And it's like, you've waited for this, now it's here. This is, look at this, Seven of Pentacles, okay, it's about waiting, okay, she's pregnant here. The Magician, it's all about creation. The Ace of Wands, the Knight of Wands, somebody here really could be, just be careful. If you're not trying to, you know, make a family, be careful. But you guys do love each other, and that's very apparent here. But this person is just, they're deciding to move towards you, but they're not making changes yet. It's like, look at that, a new romantic cycle begins, Libra energy. It's like they're heating things up with you, but they're still not making enough changes. It's like this person, you've missed them. You wanted to be with this person. I feel like they are telling you though, you know, my partner, we're sleeping in different rooms. We're not really together anymore intimately. I filed for divorce. I'm moving out, but they're still legally married. Does that make sense? Kind of that energy. We still got to be quiet. This person's really all about you. They've come in at you full force with this kind of energy. Okay. It's very sudden. It's very shocking. Like, you were not expecting this person. But it's like, I mean, I think you're enjoying the energy, but I think be cautious here because you're investing more, it feels, than they are. It's like you're empathetic and understand why they're not making these dramatic changes in order to give you what you deserve. But at the same time, you have to protect your own heart here. I mean, I feel like things are definitely heating up. I think things are definitely getting a little bit spicy for the two of you, but I feel, be careful with this one. All right, Cancer, this was your reading. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. I am wishing you all strength and many blessings. Bye-bye.